Well, good morning or afternoon. Guess what? I have been tagged again. I don't know what it is. Maybe, excuse me. Not trying to be cool here. It's the only way I can eat apples or it gets in my teeth. I don't know if it's because nobody's out to hiking, but it just seems like past couple months we're in Tagsville. I don't mind being tagged, so don't get me wrong there. It's fine. I love making a video, so this goes right along with being a YouTuber. However, this particular tag, let me get up here real close and explain this. This tag came from a source that we had a special arrangement where he wouldn't tag me and I wouldn't tag him. And so, Senior Hiker 77, John, hey, thumbs up if we got an agreement, right? Yeah, okay. So anyway, I've been tagged by John, and I'm happy to do this too because Nicole hikes a lot, tagged him. And who can refuse that sweet girl? She's awesome. So I will go along with this, but I wasn't supposed to tag me. Oh, and John, John, senior hiker. Oh, I'm 99 years old. I'm a weekend hiker. I'm a weekend warrior. You seen that guy? He's got that little chair. He gets right up out of that chair, wipes his camera off, moves around. He's out there every weekend. He says, we don't love back. He's out there. He's out there. Oh, and he started by prepping. John, senior hiker, he could prep a whole village, small village. He's got so many tents, so many backpacks, cooking sets, you name it. You know what? I bet if you were looking for, instead of toilet paper during this pandemic, and you were looking for ramen, can't find it. You know why? John's got it all. He's got all the ramen. So, I am just ragging on you, my friend. I guess it's just jealousy rears its ugly head because I'm not out there backpacking. But I love you, buddy. And we'll get together soon. So, here is this episode of Why I Love Backpacking. Well, long, long, long time ago, in a faraway land, in the Catskill Mountains of New York, as a young guy, I spent every waking moment in the woods, fishing, camping, hunting, trapping, you name it. I was out there every day. As far as backpacking goes, I don't even know if I knew what that terminology was. I don't even know if I had one of those aluminum, frame, big giant backpacks or whatever, but I always seemed to be ending up in the woods with a bunch of friends, and we were camping out doing a lot. My family used to have one of these pop-up Coleman type of trailers that we went from the Catskills, we went up into the Adirondacks and spent time up there. So my history of this is going back to that. But years and years had passed and passed, and life goes on into different things and families and all that. It wasn't until 2000 and say 16, 17, I started to watch a lot of YouTube survivor type shows. Bushcrafting, especially. I started, prepping also. And that just morphed or just got into the backpacking scene. Next thing I know, like everybody else, I discovered Dixie and Darwin and Bigfoot and Syntax and Redbeard and a whole bunch of them out there that I couldn't get enough of it. So I said to my wife, let's go buy a whole bunch of backpacking equipment. And we'll head up onto the Appalachian Trail, not to go through hike, but just to do a long hike. And that is like one of my very first videos. I bought all this stuff and I did like, you know, like everybody did a gear loadout. So we hit, I had a big Osprey AG65. She had her Aurafit. We filled it up, make sure every pocket, everything was in there. We had everything. I remember we got a shuttle. We were dropped off at Mountain Crossings there at Neal's Gap. And we took our packs out and I put them on. I was like, holy crap. I don't know how we're going to do this. But we managed. And we managed to hike about 4 or 5 days through Georgia. And we had an awesome time. Well, that just led to more and more gear, lighter gear, small things, everything that you need for backpacking. I got online and I needed it. So, but the real reason, and I have said this in other videos of mine, I'm about a 30% into the hiking and the whole backpacking, walking. I mean, who wants to carry a shitload of weight on your back? Most people don't, but you know, I did. So that portion of it, the hiking and all that, you know, I liked it, but it was all about really getting back at camp, setting up the shelter, making a fire, collecting wood, processing wood, cooking, sitting around enjoying the stream or the woods or whatever. That was what was important to me. And that kind of brought me back to my roots where I usually like to camp a lot. And so the hiking part of it got to be where I needed to lower my weight, which I have been doing over this time. But that brings me to another thing. I really enjoy this whole sport, this whole backpacking thing, because I really do enjoy the minimalist effect, the minimalist way we do this. I can take and put a backpack on my back, walk into the woods, and have everything that I need to survive. I mean, to me, that is awesome. And that is probably one of the biggest and the number one reason why I love this so much. I love the fact of minimalizing, taking a little bit of gear, taking a little bit of everything and doing my research on it and finding out what I need to be able to survive that length of time in the woods. Now, the reason I do distances is because I like to hike back far enough where I'm not around a lot of people. And I always feel the further I hike, the further back into woods, you usually get rid of most people in the first 3 or 4 miles. After that, you start to see less and less, and you start to see more and more people that are into the same thing you are, backpacking, hiking, blah, blah, blah. And that reminds me of another thing. The other thing I love about this is the people that do this. I love meeting these people out here. I don't know if it's a like-minded thing. They all are into the same type of backpacking, camping. They're all into gear. They're all into, you know, just being out in nature. And I right now I miss all that. So being that and my gear itself and the minimalist part of it, the friendship amongst other hikers, and just the beauty of the places that I go really makes me enjoy this sport. So that's it. That's it in a nutshell. I enjoy this. I really do also enjoy making YouTube videos. I enjoy going out there and filming and trying to up my game all the time on doing these videos and being better at it and getting better at it. Post-editing is so much fun. I mean, I do enjoy doing that. So that's all part of it also. So it all fits together in there. And so I was tagged. And, you know, thank you, John. You know, nah, I'm not going to do this. I mean, you know, I could say game on, you know, but I won't do that. So who am I going to tag? I'm not going to tag anybody. I'm the Tag Killer. New name, Tag Killer. I think it's fun watching these, but I don't want to put that pressure on anybody. See, unlike Senior Hiker 77, I don't go down that road. Again, John, I love you. So what is my upcoming? Well, upcoming trips. Well, this is first week of May. This weekend, I think Thursday, my wife, myself, and my dog, Dexter, we are headed up to the Foothills Trail. We're going to do two or three nights up there. I'm not sure exactly where I'm going. I'm doing my research right now. I've contacted some people up there, and they're telling me what trailheads are open. The trail is open, but certain trailheads aren't open in the park. And so I'm going to go up there, and we're going to find a place, park. We're going to do an in and out, and I'm going to figure that out somehow, and just try out some new gear. My wife's got her new Z-Pax Nero backpack. We want to try that. And I got some other gear that I'll show you when we're up there. And hopefully the weather will be great. I was looking to go to Talladega, go see As a Crow Flies, go up in his area there. But I was noticing this weekend, it's supposed to rain. We've got temperatures of like in the high 80s, warmer nights. I mean, I can do that here in Florida. I don't need to do that there. So I was looking at the Foothills Trail, and we look like we've got like 70s at night. I mean, excuse me, 70s and low 80s during the day, and 50s and low 60s at night. So perfect for me. Hopefully there's not a lot of bugs or anything, but that's where we will be this weekend. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you subscribe here. And so I'm going to be posting that trip. It should be a lot of fun. It's the first really good trip out of the state of Florida that my wife and I have done in a long time, and with my dog. So it should be real interesting. So if you like this channel, if you like this content, I'd appreciate if you subscribe. And thank you for following Walker's World. You guys have a great day, and I will see you soon. So, good apple.